Still alive. I wonder if God's helping me. Or just mocking me.
Keeper? Am I?
This too shall pass, I suppose.
Stay out of the fog. It bites.
Nice old rotten log. I bet it grows mushrooms at night. I should come back and see if it does.
On pirate ships.
You don't eat fresh veg or fruit. Teeth start to fall out. You can't see at night. When's the last time you had fresh veg? I'll give you a hint. Bee meat ain't a veg.
You've never been terribly precise what it is.
Oh, don't you start with that again.
Well then, today I learned about.
You will do well to develop a well-rounded understanding of your environment.
It was awful to say.
What's going on then? Don't make me come find you.
Ah! There! All the blood on his hands. Ow! Black dog.
Can't we just agree to disagree?
Take all this with you. It's been a hard day's night, that was.
At least we could have not done it for them.
How are you holding up?
I'm tired of fighting and running all the time.
So
drop some stuff, Arthur, or it's going to be tediously slow going.
Plus side, I suppose now I know what I'm made of.
Ralph, you're not a bloody mule. Pick what you can carry easily.
If I hadn't smoked in high school, I could carry a bit more.
The mark of Cain was to protect him. People forget that.
I wonder if changelings were just what people used to call people like Percy.
How long is the night?
Stuff? You better throw something away before something starts chasing you.
Hello. And welcome to today's edition of Humor Hour, the show where you tell me jokes. Well, I tell the joke, but you send it in. And the first joke comes from Nigel Plaskett of the Park. Dear Uncle Jack, I love your show, and Humor Hour is my favorite. Here's one I heard in the park. A man walked into the doctor's office. Yes, and he comes up from
toys and tiny beds. Tiny beds in every house.
What happened to the gardens? We used to have gardens.
You're not eating properly. That's excellent, Mr. Plaskett. Very good. I can certainly think of better ways to eat a banana, if I could get one.
At least we're alive. Right.
Where are the Americans? Where are the Russians? Ha!
Drop some stuff, Arthur, or it's going to be tediously slow going.
And here's one today from our faithful contributor, Mr. Kapersky Blackjack.
Rest in my feet. Who's out here somewhere? Or is she finding a way out?
But Jeremy kept walking. I ran over to him and I... God, man, didn't you notice your wife just fell in a manhole 100 feet back? Oh, thank goodness.
I've always sort of liked the night. Quiet. Aside from the occasional scream.
So thoughtful of you, Mr. Pike. I do hope they got her out of the sewer. One less time.
Gonna die.
Hey, what was that?
You did it, didn't you?
Can't we work something out?
Oh, God. I feel terrible. Thanks, mate. I think I nearly... It's a bit vomity, but I got most of the motiline back in there.
Is there a room for me on your log?
My God, Eric. How long have you been out here?
Just last week. I thought there'd be more of us, actually. So many people are gone from the village.
Most of us don't last very long.
Oh. When did you...
2 months ago. We think we must have got a bad batch of joy.
Oh. So, you're still with... Harold.
I'm supposed to meet him in half an hour.
Don't go.
I'll get into trouble if I don't go soon.
Don't go yet.
Well, that's a rather awkward way to catch up on old times. To sleep, perchance to dream.
Well, I hope you're indoors by now. The fog is rolling in.
Except for the night, we would never know the stars.
The fog is rolling in, and you know who's in it. No, I'm sure you're all safely in bed.
I didn't know if you'd come.
I didn't know if I would.
I hope you didn't get in trouble.
No. I've become a superb liar, actually.
Is that a bruise?
No. Oh, that. It's sold. The garden district isn't a walk in the park, you know. How's your wife?
I don't know. Probably quite happy. She's very careful to take her joy. I'm sure she's already forgotten why I'm not in the kitchen making tea. Later she'll wonder if I've gone on holiday.
I'm sorry.
She was in the mob that chased me, you know. I think by the end of it she couldn't even remember who they were all chasing. Do you ever wonder if...
Every day, Eric. Every day. But things are the way they are.
That's rather tragic, really. I seem to have had awful timing.
Thank you.
You've made your bed, Arthur, haven't you?
Everything all right?
I couldn't get away right away. He's become jealous.
Of?
You.
Me?
I told him I'd run into you, and he started asking me how long we'd been seeing each other behind his back.
I know when people go wakey-wakey, things happen to your brain.
He's always been jealous of you.
We haven't seen each other in 10 years.
I used to mention you to him sometimes.
Oh?
That's why I couldn't stay in touch.
Oh.
It's why I shouldn't be here.
Christ. She still loves him. I hope he knows that. Men can be awfully dense. When he woke up, he realized it had all just been a bad dream.
Gather round, and I'll tell you a bedtime story. After a while,
odd how the fog only comes at night.
Lovely day for it.
Doesn't quite have the same ring to it here, does it?
I thought we could stroll along the shoreline.
I can't.
Or we could stay right here.
I can't leave him. I know you want me to.
If he's not right in the head...
He needs me. He loves me in his own way.
Do you need him?
Don't be clever. I don't want to remember you as merely clever.
Remember me?
We can't do this anymore.
I found a hardware shop. Fantastic stuff. On Lymore Avenue by the Hollow. I want you to have it. If I can't be with you.
That's far too kind of you.
You probably shouldn't go yourself. That neighbourhood's a bit rough.
I'll tell Harold.
Don't tell him it's me. Obviously.
You're very generous.
What is he up to?
Anyway, you can't be picky about your foods these days. Throw your other shoe at the mouth, and he'll never bother you again. So little Red Riding Hood threw her right shoe at the mouth and killed it. Never bothered her again.
Oh, your move, Sandman. I suppose they'll be rolling up the pavements about now.
You changed your mind.
Harold's dead.
That's terrible. Who did it?
He didn't come back from the hardware shop.
Oh, God. It's rougher than I thought, I guess.
Was it you?
Was it me?
I want you to swear it wasn't you.
I swear it wasn't me.
I couldn't be with you if it was you.
I swear by the gods of my people, it wasn't me.
Kiss me. Please, kiss me.
Suppose we won't need all of this.
Well, that's a happy ending. Except for Harold, I suppose. Oh, come on, you pack rat. You can't take all this with you. funny. Percy would probably have preferred the Garden District, the way things are now.